We're making huge progress in our 21-day portfolio. And if it feels like we're nearing the end, we are. But there's still interactions and accessibility and design review and SEO settings. So in reality, yes, we are making incredible progress, but there's still a lot to consider as we move forward. This lesson is going to focus on reCAPTCHA validation to reduce spam in our contact forms. And it's going to cover responsiveness across all breakpoints, desktop, tablet, mobile landscape, mobile portrait, and the outdoor theater in Bryant Park. So, reCAPTCHA, Google's CAPTCHA, completely automated public Turing test to tell computers and humans apart. In other words, it trips up robots in an attempt to reduce spam. How do we add it? Well, we can just add a reCAPTCHA element anywhere inside our form block. So let's make sure we're on the base breakpoint, and we'll double-click to edit our contact form. Remember, we're editing a symbol here. That means changes here will affect every contact form everywhere. So we're editing the symbol. Let's go ahead into our add panel and we're going to add reCAPTCHA from here. Under forms, we have reCAPTCHA. Let's use the navigator to place this precisely. We'll put it inside the form and we'll put it in between the message area and the submit button.
That's it?
What's up?
Normally you talk more.
Did you want us to talk more?
Yeah, how is your day?
Good.
Okay.
Let's continue setting up our reCAPTCHA validation, and we'll go to our project settings to do that. So, project settings, let's head over to forms, and we'll want to scroll down to reCAPTCHA validation. There's two things here, a site key and a secret key. Let's go and register for a new key. Now, we're going to ignore this existing data on this test account. Instead, we're going to press the plus button. This will create reCAPTCHA for a new site. So, that site, let's add one right here. Megan Garcia Portfolio. This element integrates using reCAPTCHA V2, so we'll use reCAPTCHA V2. We're gonna make sure the I'm not a robot checkbox is checked to reduce the number of robots checking this box. And we're going to add two domains right here. The first one we'll add is garciaux.com. Press return. And the second one we wanna add is our staging domain. So let's go back to Webflow. We'll go back to our general settings. This is where we can either copy this one, this subdomain, right to our clipboard, or we can change it if now is the time we want to change our subdomain. We're going to keep it like this, megangarciaportfolio.webflow.io. We'll go to reCAPTCHA, paste that in, .webflow.io. And the reason we're doing both of these domains is to ensure later when we publish our site on Megan's custom.com domain, it works there. And we want it to, in the meantime, and anytime we're on the staging domain, we want it to work on the staging domain too, so we can accurately test our reCAPTCHA element. Hit return, and both have been added. We're going to accept the reCAPTCHA terms of service, send alerts to owners. We're going to keep that on so we get notifications if anything's not working properly. Then we'll press submit. That's a coincidence, a site key and a secret key. We've seen this before. So let's go copy our site key and we'll go back to Megan Garcia Portfolio. We'll go back to forms and we're gonna go down here and paste in the site key, just pasting in what we copied to our clipboard. Back to reCAPTCHA, copy the secret key, back to the portfolio, paste the secret key. The final thing we wanna do is enable reCAPTCHA. Now, when this is enabled, all forms will be validated, all forms throughout the project. Forms that do not contain a reCAPTCHA field will fail to submit. Let's save our changes and very carefully read this dialog box, which is clearly stating that we have to make sure all our forms include the reCAPTCHA component before we enable this, as they'll fail to submit unless we have the reCAPTCHA element properly added to each form. Again, if you're adding this to an existing site, this change will go into effect immediately before the next publish. Let's enable reCAPTCHA. And let's scroll up to go back to the designer. But that's setting up reCAPTCHA. Let's move on to test responsiveness on this page. So we're back on the contact page. We have our reCAPTCHA element. Again, this is located in reCAPTCHA and we're on desktop. We're on our base breakpoint. We may want to make an adjustment to the reCAPTCHA element. So we can add margin on the top just to push it off from the next element, maybe 10 pixels on top. We're just eyeballing it right now. Let's press back to instance. So we're no longer editing that symbol. And let's test responsiveness and fluidity. So if we grab the boundary, if we grab the edges of the viewport, let's click and drag and test how this is working. So far, reCAPTCHA is working fine. The rest of the form looks good. We've done this before, but we're checking what this static page looks like. Everything looks good on desktop. Let's move on to tablet. Again, same thing. We're going to test responsiveness and fluidity. The heading still seems to fit. The H1 still seems to fit. One thing to note, and we're going to do a design review later to catch things like this, but it might be worth noting that if we go back here, this is an H1, and even if we go back to our homepage, This is an H1. Each of our secondary sections starts with an H2. This is a little more specific, so this is an H3. But if we go down to our contact form and we click in here, it's still an H1. We might want to go into the cog and make this an H2, a heading 2, so that hierarchically our pages make a little more sense. In fact, if we leave this, if we stop editing the symbol, we know that change carried through to the contact page. So now we have a proper H1. I'd love to hear from you. And if we double click in here, we have the H2. Let's work together. Of course, changes to headings like that affect all breakpoints. So let's go back in. We're in tablet. And of course, it's an H2 there as well. So we're looking pretty good. Let's move on to mobile landscape. Now, you'll notice the moment we switch between tablet and mobile landscape, this heading gets smaller. Remember, we created the larger heading class as a duplicate. We duplicated the heading class and went back when we were in base breakpoint, when we created this in the last lesson, and we changed a lot of this. We changed specifically the size, the height, the color. But when we duplicated that class, it brought with it other changes. So it brought back the changes on mobile landscape. So those are size and height differences. Maybe we want to increase this. Hold down Option and drag. Maybe that looks a little bit better. But keep in mind, if we test fluidity, it kind of knocks that to the next line. Maybe not so great. Let's reduce it. 36 looks pretty good. As for the rest of it, everything's wrapped in our container class. And we know our container class is already configured on each breakpoint. So that looks pretty good. Again, testing that fluidity looks great. Noticing now that our footer could go through one change, we could always catch this later, but let's grab our text blocks here. Let's grab our collection item, or the collection list itself, and let's set its children to center. That looks a little bit more balanced. We can always make changes to this later. Escape, so that we're no longer editing the footer. Okay, let's go to mobile portrait. Now, on mobile portrait, it's a disaster. Why? Well, because the reCAPTCHA validation is hanging off the edge. And the reCAPTCHA element itself needs a little customization to make this work on a much more narrow viewport. So we're going to do that right now. First, let's make sure we're inside the form block. We've double-clicked to edit our symbol. And we're going to wrap our reCAPTCHA element with a div block. So let's click the reCAPTCHA. Let's do Command-K to enter quick find. Let's do div block, press return. And we'll just drag our reCAPTCHA element inside a div block. With the div block selected, let's go over to our style panel and add a class. We'll call it reCAPTCHA wrapper. And if we go down, we can actually transform the size. We can transform all of it. Let's make sure we're actually locking to the top left. We'll set our transform origin, so it kind of anchors on the top left. And what that means is this. When we go and add our transform, let's scale it. The scaling will occur around the top left of the element. Now, it looks super tiny on the screen, but this is scaled at 0.7. And we can test what it looks like on different device widths. In fact, let's go and grab this. Let's see what it looks like on an iPhone. There's the iPhone 12, 12 Pro. Even on narrow devices, it looks okay. The only device it kind of hangs off the edge with still is going to be the Nintendo Entertainment System, which, yes, that's accurate. However, one thing to note on our contact form on all pages here is this amount of padding on the sides might be a little much on mobile portrait. So with our form block selected, let's go back up to padding. Let's see what would happen if we reduce this maybe to 15 pixels on each side. Or even because of our limited screen real estate, let's do 10 pixels on all sides. That looks a lot better. Okay, and as a final step, let's go back to our large breakpoint, 1920. Let's go back to our instance so we're no longer editing the contact form. And this looks pretty good. Maybe the larger heading could be even larger. It has a maximum width. Let's set that to, let's actually remove that maximum width here and set the size to 335.
Stop doing that again. Stop.
But that's it for now. We secured our contact form to reduce the chances of spam messages reaching our fictional UX designer. We also made sure it responded and was fluid on all device breakpoints, including desktop, tablet, mobile landscape, mobile portrait, and larger, the 1920 pixel breakpoint. Up next in the course, we'll set up and optimize our search settings, how people will find Megan's portfolio site on search engines like Google.
I've received some pretty, how do you say, interesting messages on Twitter, Instagram, and LinkedIn. And I want to thank everyone for sharing their progress. It keeps me going. Almost as much as these Duracell brand batteries.
Those are Energizer.
No, it's Duracell. I can see it. I see what I want to see.